King's Country, kingscountry.net. Jim King of the radio behind the wheel as we cruise into a long holiday weekend, July 4th weekend. July 4th comes on a Tuesday this year, so lots of people will be having a long weekend, maybe a five-day weekend. I'll have to check with my boss. Oh, I'm self-employed. I forgot. That means I have to work every day. Kip Moore was asked what July 4th means to him, and he had a lot to say. Check it out here.
I'm a very, very patriotic person, proud of the country that I live in. I'm very proud of what those guys do for us each and every day, and I don't take it for granted one bit. You know, both my grandparents were in the military and fought in wars, and, you know, I've seen the battle they've gone through, just the horror of remembering things, and I can't imagine. You know, when I start to think I'm halfway tough, I realize how I'm not one bit when I talk to some of the soldiers when I'm out and realize the things that they go through. I can't imagine facing what those guys face every single day.
King's Country at kingscountry.net. Jim King of the radio behind the wheel on a Thursday that feels like a Friday because I got to turn in my projects today. And there goes Rick Trevino running out of reasons to run. And now I know why I'm having a fabulous flashback. Hold on tight, boys and girls.
King of the road.
Backstage in Beaumont with Rick Trevino.
The Grammy Award winning. Rick Trevino, congratulations again. You must still have to pinch yourself every morning you wake up because that happened, it was a little while ago, 1998, with the Low Super 7.
Yeah, I still sleep with my Grammy. You know, I have a little.
Do you?
Yeah, I just put it right here.
You polish it every day?
I polish it and I sleep with it.
Uh-huh. All right. Will you send me a picture of that?
Sure, man. I got my thumb right here and my Grammy over here.
All right.
Beaumont, Texas, make some noise out there.
King of the Road.
I told you on the day we went, I was going to love you.
KingsCountry.net. The band Perry. You don't hear much about them anymore, but they were red hot when that came out. Had a good run early 2000s to about the mid to late 2000s, the band Perry. They're siblings. Beautiful girl and two brothers. Two handsome brothers. And the nicest folks you could ever meet. I met them at Starvin' Marvin's. Years ago, rest in peace, Darvin Marvin. I think we're approaching the anniversary of his birthday. His birthday's coming up. The late, great Darvin Marvin. Anyway, I'm just Jim King. Stay with me.
The King of Country.
I need one of them hats like that.
It's called a Crown Boy hat.
Crown Boy hat. Okay, good, good, good. It's quite becoming.
Jim King.
King's Country at kingscountry.net. There's no excuses anymore. You can listen to us anywhere thanks to modern technology. These new vehicles that come out have Bluetooth. Very easy to stream us through your smartphone via your Bluetooth. Or at home, I like to roll with Alexa smart speaker. Just say, Alexa, play King's Country from TuneIn. You're locked into the most magnificent country music mix on the planet 24/7, 365. And yours truly in the award-winning Jim King of the radio show, multi-award-winning. But the music is the star here. Every tune cherry-picked by our music director, Mickey Ashworth. Here comes another one, another good ditty picked. Charlie Pride, Kiss an Angel, Good Morning.
Whenever I chance to meet some old friends on the street.
Streaming from the studio of King of the Road Productions in Beaumont, Texas. Jim King of the Radio behind the wheel and TV. I do that too. We do it all at King of the Road Productions. We do closed captioning. We do sales. We do TV production. We do on camera, off camera. We do radio. Doing it now. Don't miss the TV show this weekend, episode number 881, for those of you keeping track. We're going to close it out with Ethan Wayne. He hadn't been in the royal spotlight in 7 years, so inviting Ethan Wayne back into the royal spotlight. I think he's a Louisiana product. We have the Southeast Texas debut of Jordan Rayner's new video as our Taylor Trading Company music clip of the week from Nashville. We have the Honky Tonk Texas fabulous flashback with the Grammy Award-winning Kentucky Headhunters. Speak of the devils. Love those guys. Here's a little taste test of the show.
Go back, get ready. Hang on to your bridges. Hey!
You guys are like Southern rockers, really, aren't you?
Yeah.
To the core.
Yeah.
But the thing of it is, we really did fit. We were very, very lucky boys because we've been trying for years and years in rock and roll with working with Capricorn and Swan Song Records and all that. And, you know, it's just somebody that told us in the 70s we was going to put an album out that's going to work country music. We'd have laughed them out of the room.
Uh-huh.
But we were very, very fortunate that it did work. And, you know, it gave us a foundation to build on our blues roots, our rock roots, and that sort of thing. And but God bless the Lord for giving us the opportunity. And then we, you know, as we've been able to go on and make many, many albums of different styles of music. And Greg says it best. Greg always says some albums we put out are platinum records and others are like cardboard, you know. But it's listen, it's what we do is it ain't for everybody, you know.
But a lot of people love it. You have a huge following everywhere you go, especially up in northern states, I believe.
Well, everywhere. I mean, we've been lucky. I mean, it's just you know, we of course Dumas Walker's been a calling card for us.
Right.
Greg always says that nobody cares about anything but Fred's drum solo and Dumas Walker.
Well, they know Dumas Walker bought the house.
Yeah.
Check out the Kentucky Headhunters kicking off the King of the Road show, Jim King of the TV show, this weekend on Fox 4 and the CW. Coming soon to Strike TV. And speaking of Strike TV, if you missed the 880th episode, there's a grand encore airing this afternoon, at actually this evening, at 8 p.m. on Strike TV. Don't you dare miss it, and thanks for streaming King's Country.
Says she's had enough of me. I've had enough of her, too.
King's Country at kingscountry.net with George Dearborn. He's a local guy. Good song. Got some local talent here on the radio on King's Country. George Dearborn, he's been on my show several times. He has an interesting story. He was the house band when Tracy Byrd and Mark Chestnut got their deals in Nashville. George Dearborn became the house band, and he was well on his way to having a solid career, but he decided the lifestyle just wasn't for him. He was raising a young family at the time and decided to just hang it up for about 20 years and take a day job. And then a few years ago, he got back on the saddle, got back in the saddle and in the game. He's doing really well, playing all over the state. Got a lot of fans, too, George Dearborn. Got to pay a couple of bills. Quick timeout. Sam Riggs, transplanted Texans. Sam Riggs coming up next on King's Country. You stay right
King
there.
King of the Road.
Backstage in Beaumont with rising country star Sam Riggs.
You're a transplanted Texan originally from Florida.
Yeah.
and moved in to Austin in 2007. I think due to a CD that you heard from Reckless Kelly because of the music scene there in Austin?
Yeah, I'd heard a mixed CD, a burn CD, with Reckless Kelly was on there. I think there was some Randy Rogers and Wade Bowen, you know, a friend of mine that bales hay out in Crockett, Texas, came back with it. And, you know, it was Clay O'Berry, and he came back with it. And I was like, man, that sounds just like where I need to be. So that was a big factor in me moving to Austin.
Coming from the studio, King of the Road Productions in Beaumont, Texas, gearing up for another TV weekend, episode number 881, set to air this weekend, but who's counting? We're going to have Ethan Wayne in the Royal Spotlight, a place he hasn't been in 7 years, going to re-air something that he recorded here in the studio. Ethan Wayne from Louisiana. We'll also have the Southeast Texas debut of Jordan Rayner's new video. She's an Oklahoma girl that was raised in Texas. She's got a good new song called Straight Shot. You need to check that out. That's sponsored by Taylor's Trading Company. It's the Taylor Trading Company Music Clip of the Week from Nashville. We're going to kick it off with a couple of killer segments with my good friends, the Grammy Award-winning Kentucky Headhunters. Taste test time. Check this out.
Extra large and turbocharged. It's the King of the Road Show.
Oh, hi, yo, to the game.
One man has the power to take you behind the scenes. Jim King of the Road.
There is a house in New Orleans.
Kentucky Headhunters, the Grammy Award-winning Kentucky Headhunters. I think it's your first time here at Honky Tonk, Texas.
I believe it is. As far as I know.
We're close to Beaumont, though, aren't we?
Yes, you have a lot of fans in Beaumont. Thanks partly because of our TV show that we've featured you on so many times.
I appreciate that. Yeah,
last time we saw you was in Louisiana. It's probably 5-6 years ago, and you're like, in our royal archives now.
Hey, man. Well, you're the king, man. You got that's the coolest cowboy hat I own.
I think it is, too.
I'm not a real king. I just play one on TV once a week.
Well, that's all right. That's enough.
Well, three times a week.
Have you ever wore that at a bar or anywhere?
Yeah.
Did you ever get in trouble?
No. Can you believe I never got my ass kicked?
I can't believe it. If I was to put that on my head and walk in a bar with a cowboy hat on, they'd take me out.
I don't know. We're at a biker rally, so I'll just keep it on the bus this time.
Yeah, it might be a good idea.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's a nice hat, it is.
But you guys, why we remember you, though.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's your hat.
Right. Hopefully I have more than just that. But anyway, this is about you guys, the Grammy Award-winning Kentucky Headhunters, ACM winners, CMA nominated.
All that stuff fell on us at one time.
Our first single came out in our album in October of 89.
Nashville.
Yeah, well, the single.
Okay.
Yeah, walks off.
Yeah.
Well, we...
we always, I guess, claim to be more of a 90s because the 80s period of country music definitely wasn't what we were about, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, we kind of just dropped in on them out of nowhere.
Well, doing we came in there and sealed the end of the 80s. The 80s.
Started the 90s.
Yeah. it was a real abrupt change, too, because they were trying to be like pop artists down there, and they still do, but like... Then all of a sudden, here comes this loud amplifier.
We do the Bose Farm Boogie. We do the Bose Farm Boogie.
One more time for Louisiana.
Do the Bose Farm Boogie.
Now there's boogie!
Check out the Kentucky Headhunters 3 times this weekend on Fox 4, the CW, coming soon to Strike TV, probably next week. And thanks for speaking to me, guys. King's Country, kingscountry.net. We're cruising into a long holiday weekend, July 4th weekend. It's going to be a firecracker of a weekend in Southeast Texas. It is so hot. Going to get out, maybe get out and about and watch some fireworks, maybe a parade or two. Well, here's comedian Ryan Hamilton on his small town's 4th of July parade. Check this out.
We have a big parade every year on the 4th of July. It's the biggest event in my town every year. There are 500 people in the parade and 500 people who are watching the parade. We have exactly enough people to have a parade. If someone stays home, they're kind of ruining the parade. Here's what I love about the parade is after it's over, nobody leaves. Nobody has anywhere to go. There's only one suitable street in my town for a parade. And when the parade gets out of town, it doesn't know what to do either. And there's this moment of confusion, and then it just flips around and it comes back. Everybody just watches the other side of the parade again.
Thanks for streaming King's Country. That's Dan and Shay. Tequila. Don't drink too much of that stuff. Could be dangerous. I'm Jim King of the radio. Cruising on out of here. Go work on some other projects. I got the Jim King of the TV show I'm doing closed captioning on as I speak. And the two church shows are being turned in today. It's deadline time at King of the Road Productions. Good work if you can get it, I guess. It's a lot of work, but I love it. Anyway, you keep between the ditches. Have a good one. Have a great July 4th weekend. If you don't hear from me tomorrow, I think I might be out of pocket a little bit. So do keep between the ditches and stay tuned for Fair and Young coming up right after these on King's Country. Later, Gators. Happy July 4th.